In this video, I'm going to explain 4 steps to go from insecure to confident, or to go from confident to extremely confident. So keep watching. Number 1, create mental proof. Okay, let me give you an example, right? Let's say you are a footballer, whether a guy or a girl, you play football, that's what you do. Somebody just calls you and says, I'm going to get a match we're supposed to play this Saturday. Now, small cup shots, just community cup where they play, you go feel play, you go feel show. If you are somebody who has been playing football for, let's say, 5 to 10 years of his or her life, this is something you have been doing for years in your life, your brain immediately does the calculations for you. You know in your mind that, man, this is something I've been doing for years, nothing did there. Sure, I go show, nothing is up, I go did there, I'll be there, you get. But if you, maybe for example, just started playing basketball, I love basketball too much. If, for example, you're somebody who just started playing football recently, let's say this year or last year, your mind now will tell you, like, your brain has already done the mathematics and it's telling you that, oh, you don't know how to play, you're not that good yet, you know, you're not on that level to play community cup or anything. That's what creating mental proof is. If you are in a situation, bah, and your brain can look back and say, guy or babe, you have been in this situation multiple times before, nothing did yet. Then you'll be confident. You know, mental associations are a thing, mental proof is a thing. When your brain can look back and say you have done this thing 10-20 times, there's nothing there, you will do them again. That is a very important part of being confident, and to me that is the most effective way of being confident, where you can create moments for yourself, you know, create moments in your life. That's what I keep talking about. That's what I keep talking about, putting yourself out there, you know, making yourself uncomfortable, doing things that you would normally do every day, you know, just putting yourself out there. So if you eventually find yourself in that kind of situation, and it is very important that you know, execute, it's very easy, you feel confident because your brain can just do the math for you and be like, guy, nothing did there, you go run up. Number 2, accept anxiety. What anxiety is basically your body being pumped with dopamine. Anxiety is basically your body gingering you. Oh my guy, this is what you want to do now, they're very important. That's what it is saying. It's not saying, don't do this thing, this stuff is scary, stop, don't do it. No, that's not what anxiety is. Fear is different from anxiety, right? The kind of anxiety you feel when you are in a new situation or you're about to do something that's important is good, it's not bad. You know, don't reason it as the bad thing, you get. Once you accept that anxiety is a part of life, sometimes you might not even be in a new situation, you will just feel it, and then you start feeling some negative thoughts of, maybe I should not do this thing, or I don't think I can do this thing, I'm feeling anxious. Anxiety is not bad. Anxiety is not a bad thing. Once you can accept anxiety for what it is, which is just your body just pumping you up, you know, gingering you, okay, this stuff you're doing right now is important, you don't want to mess it up. That's basically what it is. It's not in any way saying stop or you can't do it. It's not a limiting thing. Once you accept anxiety, then you can be more confident, because when you are feeling that anxiety now, right, it's kind of like I saw in one video, who made that video? I can't remember who made the video, but I saw it in a video where they said if two people are in a roller coaster ride, but two of them are feeling anxious, one person's mind, person is like, God, we think we'll stop, what if Nepal take light, what if electricity fails, what if this thing breaks and I fall and I die? That's anxiety the person's feeling. But the second person can also be anxious and be like, Jesus Christ, I've never been this kind of thing in my life, God. You know, it's also anxiety, right? But it's different interpretations. So it still comes down to interpretation. If you understand that anxiety is not a bad thing, it's just something you feel when you are in a new situation or in a scary situation, then you'll be more confident. Number 3 is dress better. Now this one seems like common knowledge, it seems like something everybody should know. But believe it or not, the way you dress affects the way you think about yourself. It affects what you think about yourself. I promise you, if you look at yourself in the mirror before you leave the house, and in your mind you know, say, man, I'm a freaking speck, you know that you look really attractive, it affects your confidence. It boosts your confidence a little bit more. When you're walking on the road, the way you walk is very different than when you don't feel like you dress well enough. You don't necessarily have to buy the most expensive clothes like most people online make you think. The easiest, cheapest, simplest clothes, white shirt, black trouser with nice sneakers, and you look amazing, I promise you. So just looking good helps boost your self-esteem and boost your confidence. Number 4, have money. I know it sounds very shallow, but believe it or not, when you know you have a lot of money in your bank accounts, it really helps your confidence. And that's the truth, especially in a generation where we pedestalize riches, we pedestalize materialism and all that. I'm not saying it is good, but if you are being realistic, having money definitely makes you more confident. Let's not lie. It makes you very confident when you have a lot of money in your bag and you know that whatever it is you need to buy, you can buy. You can afford to put yourself in situations that most people can't put themselves in. You just kind of, you personally look at yourself in a different esteem. So having a lot of money, or having, not a lot of money, but having adequate money, you know, to take care of yourself day in, day out, also boosts your confidence. If you like the video, click on the like button. And if you're new here and you haven't subscribed, this is a self-improvement channel for young Nigerians. So if you like content like this, definitely hit subscribe. And don't forget, the most important part of subscribing is hitting the bell icon, turning on my post notifications. Because YouTube is big and that's the only way you see my content. So hit the bell icon right now. And also, I think the next video you should watch is the video that just popped up on the screen right now, The Simple Secret to Happiness. So click on that video. If you can't see the video, click on the first link in the description. And I'll see you guys in the next video. It could be.